Hi everybody, I'm going to show you today how to use a lathe to do some paint, to do some paintings. And these are map gas bottles, they're empty, and I'm going to make these into some wind chimes. And I want a few of them to be kind of earth tones. And I know if you don't have a lathe at home, of course, it's not going to do you any good, but it's just an interesting thing to be able to try if you can. Or maybe you could figure out your own way of how to spin this. So we're going to set this, I already got it indicated, and it's pretty well centered. That's 37 RPMs right there. So we'll start off with a base coat. Here's my colors, just black, two different shades of brown, two different greens and white. And we'll start off with some, just some light brown. Start putting a base coat on there with light brown. I've done this with some CDs already, and it actually turns out pretty cool. You never know how this is going to turn out until the job is finished, because each and every thing that you paint is completely different than the last one. Which in a way is really nice. You just never know what you're going to wind up with. Just use your brush to push it and move it across the part. Just starting off with a large brush right now. Get the most of the areas covered. If some of the yellow shows through when you're done, it doesn't matter. It's okay. Because after all, if you're making it, it's up to you what's right and what's wrong. We'll mix in a little bit darker brown. This is only, what, 63 RPMs right now. Nice and slow. I'm going to slide all this together. Now I'll stop it for a second, just give you a look. That's only just with two different shades of brown, and it kind of comes up with some interesting colors. Let's continue. So I'm going to move it up to, I'm going to use the same brush. Very brilliant green, very brilliant, very bright color. And just a little bit of that mixed in with the two different shades of brown. See, if you want to tone down the green, you just push it in with the brown. Mix it together with your brush as you go, like this. And if you want a candy cane effect, you just quickly slide it. Like that. Now I'm going to mix a little bit of this dull green with a little bit of brown on the end of my brush. Kind of load this part up with this dull green. I think I call it like a leaf green or something like that, I'm not sure. Make some stripes with this leaf green. And just use all the paint that's on the brush. More leaf green. And some more of this brilliant green mixed in with it. Just makes kind of some stripes around it a little bit, some pinstriping more or less. That's looking pretty cool. And just remember, when you're doing stuff like this, it's up to you what's right and what's wrong. Now, these are going to be used as a wind chime for the side of my house. And if you guys will stay tuned, I'll show you how I'm going to make those wind chimes and how I'm going to set them up, etc. So now, okay, let's take a smaller brush. What's this one? Right here. And we'll just go with this deep black. Make some pinstripes with the black. Just apply the paint however it looks nice to you, and widen the pinstripes out by pushing the brush in a little bit harder. Just stay on it till you get a continuous line, more or less. A little more at the end there. Okay. All right. So to add a little bit of color contrast, I have some white. Let's see what that does. Just get a nice, another small brush here. And this white. This is all acrylic paint. Inexpensive, and if it chips off while it's the wind chimes are installed, it doesn't matter. It's okay. It's just for decoration. So let's see. We'll put some white pinstripes on here, just a little bit of added color, just a little bit. And I think we need some white right there. It doesn't matter if it goes all the way around the part or not. Okay. And then down here at the end, a little white. Yeah, see how it's blending in with the black and the green? Right there, that's really very nice, actually. And a little white around the top. Before I began painting this, I abraded the surface of the original yellow paint so that this paint will stick a little bit better. All right, now, let's say I want to change these colors just a little bit. It's very easy to do. I've done this one, like I said, on some CDs and DVDs already. So I want to dull down that green just a little bit. I'll take a little bit of this dark brown and just push it in with that dark, with that bright green. Take a little more of this dull brown, push it into the white. It's very simple. But the most of this is just having fun with what you're doing and making something that's creative and useful. I want to add a little more brown to this right here. And kind of tighten that up a little bit right there. Push that around. You can see how the colors just follow the brush. Change this a little bit right here. Bit darker brown. If you increase the speed, of course, it's going to feed the paint off of your brush faster, of course. I'll show you. Okay, that's 178 RPMs. And we'll dull down this white line just a bit. The longer you hold your brush in one spot, the more it blends the paints together. Now let's see. I want to add just a little bit of green in this brown patch right here. Hold it in one spot. A little bit of pressure and a little bit of time, it changes the entire color. When this stops, it's really very interesting to see how what you wind up with when this stops. So let's go ahead and bring this back down in speed. Let's mix up a little bit more bright green, and we'll put a little touch of bright green right here, and then we'll blend it in with this brown. I'm going to dull this white down just a little bit. Spread it out just a little. I'm going to mix a little bit of black on the and some of the light brown. Put that right here. Okay. Well, that part's done, so let's go ahead and stop it and see what we end up with. There's an interesting looking wind chime. You'll never be able to find another one exactly like it. But like I said, if you don't have a lathe, then you can come up with some other way of turning a part like this with a drill or a rotisserie from an old barbecue or something like that. It just all depends upon what you can come up with yourself. Now each piece, you can see how each piece looks a little bit different. Every inch of it is just a little bit different than the next. All right, thanks for watching and have a great night. Let's see what you can come up with.